Dear students, so in our last class we have completed the first unit. Now this video class is totally intended for the reviewing of the total lesson what we have discussed. So just by taking the review, I am going to conclude the total unit of your second year civics, that is Indian Constitution and Historical Developments. As at the first day of the class, we discussed about the Indian National Movement. What is the meaning of Indian National Movement? Why our leaders participated in National Movement? As you know that Britishers were ruled our country, so at that time to quit them from India, our leaders have been taken part in the National Movement. The total movement is nothing but calling as the Indian National Movement. You know that this Indian National Movement took place during the years in between 1885 to 1947. So, what are the causes we have discussed in our first two classes? That is the British colonial rule, their attitude, their discrimination policies, socio-religious cultural awareness among the people, Great Revolt, economic exploitation, English education, press, repressive acts and policies of the Britishers, discrimination, racial discrimination, and formation of the Indian National Congress. These are the basic causes for the occurrence of the National Movement during this period. So after that, we discussed about the different phases of the Indian National Movement. So even though generally this Indian National Movement was a lengthy one, it is a very lengthy one, it is very hard to study, hard to understand, so that some of the historians like R.C. Mujumdar have been divided this total Indian National Movement into three phases. This is basically for the convenience of study. And during this Indian National Movement, different leaders were participated. So different opinions have expressed, different types of weapons they have used, so that their, based on their objectives, based on their activities, and for the study of convenience, this Indian National Movement have been totally divided into three stages. That is the moderate stage, and extremist stage, and Gandhian stage or Gandhian phase. You know that moderate stage is in between 1885 to 1905, and extremist stage is in between 1906 to 1919. and Gandhian stage is the final stage, that is the 1920 to 1947. Here moderates are Dadabhai Nauroji, Umesh Chandra Banerjee, Gopalakrishna Gokhale. Like that, people are the followers of the Britishers. They show loyalty, faithfulness towards to the British people. They want only reforms in the existing administration. They followed the methods of petition, prayer and mediation. They never opposed the British policies, whereas extremists are quite opposite to moderates. They criticized the moderates. The extremists always believed that for existing poor conditions of Indians are because of the policies of the Britishers only. And the Lord Curzon's cruel policies, partition of Bengal, are few of the basic reasons for the existence of extremism in our country. Arabindo Ghosh, Bala Gangadhar Tilak, Lala Lajapati Rai, Bipin Chandra Pal are the few of the important leaders of the extremist phase. And Gandhian phase is the last phase. Here Gandhi took over the leadership of the Indian National Movement during this period, that is from 1922 until attainment of the independence to India. He followed the technique of Satyagraha and he followed the middle path, that is not totally taken the concept of moderates, not totally adopted the policies of the extremist. This is the Gandhian stage. During moderate stage, Swadeshi movement was occurred in our country. It is the first and foremost important movement which given the path or roadway to the next to forthcoming existing movements in our country during the British period. And during extremist period, Home Rule Movement is one of the important movement. Bala Gangadhar Tilak, Annie Besant took place under them. This Home Rule Movement was taken place. And during Gandhian stage, their non-cooperation movement, civil disobedience movement and Quit India movement, these are the basic movements have been taken place during the period 1920 to 1947 during the Gandhian phase. After this topic, we have discussed the Government of India Acts. As Britishers were ruling our country, for the facilitation, the Britishers have been provided few acts to rule our country, that is our India. Those are nothing but Government of India Acts. There were so many acts are there, but especially historians may give an importance to few acts, that is the Councils Act of 1909 and 1919, 1935 and 1947. These are the basic acts, because 1909 is because of the moderate reform revolution. They have during through this act, Britishers extended the numerical strength. At the same time, they created the special electorates for the Muslims. In this way, there were few controversial issues, few basic constitutional reforms issues were included through this act by the Britishers. But Indians were not satisfied, so that again government of British introduced the 1919 Act. This is because of the extremist movement and Lord Curzon's cruel rule. The people are not in a position to bear the British government. Not only that, during that period, British wanted to participate in the First World War. So, it wanted to seek material and men support from India. So, to compensate its activities, introduced the 1919 Act. Some provisions are there, we discussed in our classes also. Next one is the 1935 Government of India Act. Main base is the Statutory Commission, that is Simon Commission's report, Civil Disobedience Movement and McDonald Communal Award are the basis for the 1935 Act. And the Government of India 1947 Act is the final act prepared by the Britishers for our country. Lord Mountbatten, the last Governor General, Attlee, the then Prime Minister of the British government, prepared and make it approved in the legislature to provide the independence to India. In this way, these are all the basic acts we have discussed in our classes. And the next one, Constituent Assembly. Our Indian Constitution was prepared by the Constituent Assembly. It is elected by the people. The Constituent Assembly, after long deliberations and discussions, prepared the Constitution for India. It has been constituted 22 subcommittees for the preparation of the Constitution. Drafting committee is one of the important committee, chaired by the Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, drafted the rough constitution. Like that, Fundamentals Committee, Women's Committee, Advisory Committee, like that too. 22 subcommittees are there, taken part in the preparation of the Constitution. At last, 26 January 1950, our Constitution came into force for our country. And the next one is the sources of Indian Constitution. From where our constitutional measures were taken, constitutional issues or topics were adopted. You know that our constitution is a not only lengthiest but also bulkiest. Not only that, it is a ideal constitution. It has been taken different types of issues, items from different constitutions of other countries. For example, Westminster model, parliamentary form of government, like that issues are taken from the Britain. And fundamental rights, impeachment of the president, judicial review, like that have been taken from the American government. Not only that, few items are also adopted from the 1919 and 1935 Act also. In this way, from Ireland, from Germany's constitution, the constitution makers have been taken few items. These are all considered as the sources for the preparation of the Indian constitution. And philosophy of Indian constitution, it is our next topic what we have discussed. Here you know that at the time of the preparation of the constitution, the old ideology, philosophy are quite different. Western countries are there, those insisted on the rights of the people. Eastern countries are there, those insisted on the liberty, justice of the people. So our constitution makers, which is ideal and what is suitable to our Indian people, Indian country, they have been taken. Like that, internationalism, Gandhiism, liberalism, rule of law, secularism, like that, these concepts are inserted in our constitution for the people of our country. And preamble was prepared and under the objective resolutions introduced by the Jawaharlal Nehru in the first meeting of the Constituent Assembly. And preamble starts with "We people of India." In this way, it's give importance to the people's sovereignty and it provides the popular sovereignty to our country of people, to our people of our country. And the next one is the salient features of Indian constitution. Salient, as I told you, important. What are the important basic features of our Indian constitution? As I told you, there are nearly 14 salient features are there. Basically, fundamental rights, fundamental duties, directive principles of state policy, parliamentary government, and India become the sovereign, secular, socialistic and democratic republic, and adult franchise, universal adult franchise, single citizenship, independent integrated judiciary, Nagarapalika Acts, bicameralism, like that 14 features, basic features of Indian constitution we have discussed in our last classes. This all the brief idea what we have discussed in our last classes during this first unit video discussion. So try to go through old videos wherever you got the doubt, or you can conclude any question regarding about these topics through WhatsApp. I can answer them. I will give the response to your questions also. For your final examination, these salient features of Indian constitution and causes of Indian national movement and stages of Indian national movement are the 10 marks important questions. Under them only, Gandhian movement, home rule movement, non-cooperation movement, like that 5 marks questions are also going to be covered. For your most of the 2 marks questions are from these salient features only. Preamble, rigid and flexibility, unitary and federal bicameralism, universal adult franchise. Like these questions are going to be asked in your final examinations. This first chapter covers you the weightage of 19 marks, that is one 10 marks question plus one 5 marks question plus two 2 marks questions are going to be asked from this chapter in your final examination. I am going to provide you few short answer questions only through WhatsApp. Just answer them and send back to me. I will evaluate how much you have listened. We be able to know after the evaluation and after the marks. So please be get it ready, and in our next class, in continuation, we are going to start the second unit also. So once please go through all these topics and videos. Thank you.